निमिषा, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल निमिषा लाइवली लाइफस्टाइल। फॉर दोस हु आर न्यू, प्लीज डू हिट द सब्सक्राइब बटन एंड आल्सो हिट द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू गेट अ नोटिफिकेशन एज सून एज आई अपलोड अ न्यू वीडियो। समवेयर अराउंड लास्ट मंथ आई हैड पोस्टेड अ वीडियो ऑन हाउ टू वॉश योर फेस करेक्टली। Just in case you missed watching that video, I will leave the link in the description. Please do watch it. So in that video, I had mentioned about different skin types, and many of you all DM'd me on Instagram asking that how do we recognize or how do we know our own skin type, and why is it so necessary that we should know our own skin type? So I thought of making a video on simple methods of how you can identify your own skin type just by sitting at home. Yes, you can find out your skin type by going to a dermatologist, but isn't it nice if you know it just by sitting at home? So in my today's video, I am going to share simple two methods where you can identify your own skin type. Before getting into the video, let us know what are the different skin types and also why is it so important to know our own skin type. So there are five general skin types usually people have. The first one is normal, second one is dry, third one is oily or acne prone, fourth one is combination skin, and fifth one is a sensitive skin. It is very important to know your own skin type when it comes to selecting your skincare products. Now let me explain it to you in detail. For an example, you are a dry skin type and you do not know your skin type and you are using a product that is formulated for oily skin, for example a face wash. What a face wash does for an oily skin, it will rip off all the essential oils or the moisture which is essential oils that is secreted from your skin. So if when you are, since you are a dry skin, if when all the essential oils or when all the moisture is ripped off, it will leave your skin very dry. So indirectly it is harming your skin. So it is very important to know your skin type before selecting a skin product. Now many of you all would come and tell that you do not use lot of skincare products, but at least a face wash is a must for everybody because it's very important to use a face wash rather than using a soap. So in today's video, I will tell you the two basic methods wherein you can identify your own skin type. So now let me tell you the two main methods wherein you can identify your skin type. The first method that I'm going to tell you is a face bard method, and second one is the blotting paper method. So let's talk about the first method, that is face bard method. In this method, what you have to do is you have to wash your face with whatever cleanser or face wash you are using and leave your face without applying any moisturizer or any serums or any doing any treatment just for 30 minutes. After this 30 minutes, you have to examine your face very closely. First, what you have to check is you have to check for your forehead. Then you have to check your nose, cheeks and chin. If you have a visible shine or if you feel there is oily secretion from these areas, then that means you are an oily skin. And if you feel your skin is very tight or very dry and you feel that you need to apply some kind of moisturizer, then definitely you are a dry skin. And if you have a visible shine on your forehead and chin, then that means you have a combination skin. In combination skin, what happens is you will have your T-zone a different type skin and your other areas, that is your cheek areas, will have a different type skin. So it could be anything. It could be an oily and a combination skin. It could be oily with dry skin. So that depends upon what kind of skin you have in your cheeks. Now moving to the second method, that is the blotting paper method. Now as the name suggests, here you need to use a blotting paper. It is available very freely in the market. You can get it from any supermarket. So this method is mainly used to identify your oily skin. So let me tell you about this method. What you have to do is you have to wash your face with whatever cleanser or face wash you are using. Do not apply any moisturizer or serums or do not do any treatment after washing your face. Just leave your face just like that. And you have to take a blotting paper and just dab your face with the blotting paper and check the blotting paper against a light, tube light or direct sunlight or whatever light you feel it is preferable for you. And in that, if you find any excess oil onto your blotting paper, that means you have oily skin. Now, if your entire face is secreting lot of oil, and if you dab the blotting paper onto your entire face and you feel there is lot of oily secretion, then you have completely oily skin. And if you have oil secretion only from the forehead or nose or chin area and not from the cheek areas, then you have a combination skin. So blotting paper method is mainly used to find out whether you are to differentiate whether you have an oily skin or you do not have an oily skin. So in these two methods, I mostly emphasized on dry skin, oily skin and combination skin. Now let me tell you something about normal and sensitive skin. Now identifying a normal skin is very easy, I feel, because normal skin people have not too oily skin and not too dry skin. They have a balanced sebum production and they have a good blood circulation too. So it's very easy to identify normal skin as they do not have much of the skin problems also. Now talking about the sensitive skin. People who have sensitive skin are more prone to rashes, acne, breakouts. They are very sensitive to sun, that is UV rays. So if you have a sensitive skin, you would get these warnings and signals when you use a new skincare product, or if you are exposing to sun and you are having lot of rashes onto your skin. So understanding or knowing if you are a sensitive skin is by closely monitoring your or closely understanding your skin type. So I feel it will not come into these two methods. So understanding your skin when you are using different skin products, or when you change to new products, or when you expose yourself to sun, is what you have to know if you feel you have a sensitive skin. That's all for today. I hope you all enjoyed my today's video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel, and also hit the bell icon so that you get a notification as soon as I upload a new video. To stay more connected, please do follow me on my Instagram page, Nimsha's Lively Lifestyle. I will come very soon with another interesting video.